SpaceX is preparing to launch its massive new rocket for its first test flight. Moving a large rocket with 33 engines to the launch pad for tests is SpaceX. A rocket with as many engines has never been launched successfully. SpaceX is a private spaceflight firm that launches satellites and astronauts to the International Space Station, or ISS. Elon Musk, the company's founder, is also developing and testing a Starship system for lunar landings, and he hopes future crewed Mars expeditions. On May 30, 2020, the business launched its first two astronauts to the International Space Station on board the SpaceX Crew Dragon, and it has since launched many more crews on behalf of NASA and other organizations. It's the only commercial spaceflight business capable of sending astronauts to space as of mid-2022, although it may soon be challenged by Boeing's CST-100 Starliner. Welcome to the new video of Cosmos Observer. On June 23rd, SpaceX's enormous Starship project was in motion as the Booster 7 Super Heavy rocket prototype was transferred to its test site in South Texas. According to Ars Technica, the Starship rocket and its first Super Heavy prototype will undergo pressure testing as well as maybe a static fire test at a location close to Boca Chica to evaluate their capacity to burn fuel steadily over time. This booster might launch Starship in an orbital test flight in July if it survives, which is by no means a guarantee given the developmental nature of the Raptor 2 engine, the article stated on June 24th. The testing program began with a Starhopper, a smaller vehicle that undertook a series of tethered and untethered flying tests in 2019 and 2020. Then in August 2020, SpaceX began testing a succession of Starship vehicles in high-altitude flights, beginning with a cautious hop test of SN5. One of the program's most difficult problems was performing mid-air flip maneuvers, which led to the demise of numerous Starships before SN15 achieved a soft landing on May 5, 2021. Starship is intended to launch into orbit and deep space aboard Super Heavy, a 230-foot or 70-meter-tall rocket with propellant tanks holding around 3.6 tons of liquid oxygen and methane. Super Heavy, like all of SpaceX rockets, is designed to be reusable. It'll have four grid fins to help regulate the booster's descent. In August 2021, the completely stacked Super Heavy and Starship were assembled on a launch pad for the first time, standing 390 feet tall. That's over 30 feet higher than NASA's enormous Saturn V moon rocket. The Starship Super Heavy variant is scheduled to execute an orbital test in 2022, pending a delayed environmental study of SpaceX launch facility in Boca Chica, Texas, by the Federal Aviation Administration. The public response to the assessment generated more data points than the FAA had anticipated, prolonging the process. Super Heavy will land vertically on Earth shortly after launch, just like the first stages of SpaceX Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets already do. And Starship will be able to go to and from Mars or the Moon several times. The success of SpaceX's Crew Dragon trips to the space station drew missions from other firms that employ similar spacecraft to perform high Earth orbit missions, ISS missions, and in one case, a crewed moon mission. Musk's Mars ambitions still include a Starship. Musk stated in a February 2022 update that it may be possible to launch one Starship vehicle every 6 to 8 hours and one Super Heavy rocket every hour on missions carrying up to 150 tons of payload into orbit. According to Musk, such a high launch rate is projected to reduce costs, making Mars settlements more financially feasible. The 230-foot-tall Super Heavy is the first stage of SpaceX's entirely reusable Starship transportation system, which is being developed to assist humanity in colonizing Mars, among other things. The upper stage is a 165-foot spacecraft named Starship, a prototype of which flew 6.2 miles in May. SpaceX intends to use the system to transport personnel and cargo to the Moon for NASA, then to Mars and other solar system destinations. But Starship has only completed a few high-altitude test flights so far. Those tests were conducted in a series between August 2020 and May 2021, and SpaceX has been waiting for the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, to complete an environmental assessment for orbital changes ever since. That procedure has just concluded, with 75 steps required for SpaceX to continue operations at Boca Chica. The FAA had already delayed the date, claiming that it needed to consult with other agencies and sift through thousands of public comments received when the draft version was issued on September 2021. Even now, however, FAA approval is not guaranteed. SpaceX must still obtain a launch license, depending on how successfully the EPA believes it handled the lingering issues in the environmental study. Elon Musk, CEO of SpaceX, tweeted that the system's long-awaited orbital test flight will take place next month. "We will have a second Starship stack ready to fly in August, and then monthly thereafter," Musk said in a subsequent tweet. For its Artemis program, which intends to land astronauts on the moon no sooner than 2025, NASA has chosen the Starship lander. Musk intends to take people to Mars around the same time, but he has a reputation for setting ambitious goals for both SpaceX and Tesla, his automaker. On March 18, 2021, SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk announced on Twitter that the large rocket at the company's South Texas facility close to the Gulf Coast community of Boca Chica was the first Super Heavy booster. Starship will have the ability to launch itself off of both of those bodies, but it'll require Super Heavy to launch itself off the much larger Earth. SpaceX has taken the Starship prototype to its absolute limits. SpaceX had to create the first stage of the launch system, known as Super Heavy, because the vehicle couldn't get into orbit on its own. Being the largest and most potent rocket ever built, the development of the rocket's ground systems and paperwork would take some time. Boca Chica's launch pads have been vacant as a result for almost a year. Even just finishing Super Heavy was a difficult undertaking. 33 Raptor rocket engines were needed for that vehicle, so the corporation needed to ramp up production to meet that demand. While this is the case, Aerojet Rocketdyne, a longtime leader in American propulsion, has set a goal of producing 4 RS-25 rocket engines a year for NASA's Space Launch System. Now, SpaceX produces at least 4 Raptor rocket engines every week. The two engines' combined power is equal. The original Raptor rocket engine was overly heavy and powerful, as acknowledged by SpaceX founder Elon Musk and his team. The company decided to delay Super Heavy's flying testing until the Raptor 2 engine was available as a result. It seems like a good decision was made. Unlike the original Raptor, which had 185 tons of thrust, Raptor 2 will have at least 230 tons, and it should also be considerably more resilient and less expensive to build once its architecture is completely established. At the South Texas location, great work has also gone into designing and building a sizable launch and catch tower. It stands more than 150 meters tall and supports the rocket when it's fully stacked during fueling and launch procedures. The first stage booster will be caught by the rocket's massive chopsticks as it slows down in close proximity to the ground minutes after launch. The design and construction phases were finished in more than 13 months. SpaceX has to upgrade its Texas-based ground support infrastructure in order to simultaneously fuel the Super Heavy and Starship rockets. The last item was the documentation. Under the initial environmental license for the Texas location, roughly 12 launches of SpaceX's smaller Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets were permitted annually. The Starship launch mechanism was outside of the scope. Therefore, the company had to go back to the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, and get approval for far more massive launches. It marked the start of a drawn-out procedure. Even though it's not yet finished, SpaceX also secured a critical decision earlier this month when it received a crucial regulatory approval. Starship test flights can now begin from Texas, according to the corporation. If the rocket passes pressure testing and even a static fire test in the next days and weeks, Starship might launch an orbital test flight. However, considering the Raptor 2 engine's continued development, this is by no means a guarantee. Despite his concurrent attempts to acquire Twitter and the unrest caused by his actions, Musk recently claimed that he anticipated an orbit launch attempt may occur in July. SpaceX has been advanced as soon as feasible by Musk. In August, the second Starship stack, according to him, would be ready for takeoff. As usual, this estimate appears unduly optimistic. All signs point to the South Texas hardware being nearly ready, though. Additionally, the documentation is being finished. An attempt to launch has become more likely this year.